Hello everyone, welcome to StudyIQ. In this video, I will finish the fourth week. Every week I divide into two parts, but this time I am not dividing the video into two parts. Only one part will come from fourth week. It has 100 questions. But please remember that the first week of December I will bring to you in three parts, because usually the first week I divide in three parts so that I can also include some of the leftover questions from the previous month. So do check that out also. This video will be in English language for my English language viewers. Now you can connect with me on Instagram on a more personal level. You can message me, talk to me, or on Twitter. I have just made an account on Twitter, so GauravGrade888, that's what you have to search. And our SSC Bank PO and UPSC courses are available. Our test series is also available for UPSC, and we are soon launching a test series for SSC and Bank PO also. So just shoot the one of the numbers given here, or just go to studyiq.com. Southeastern Railways. Now you know that railway has 17 zones in India. Southeastern Railway has started installing Asia's largest solid state interlocking system at which place? This they have done at Kharagpur. You must have heard about IIT Kharagpur. So Kharagpur is a place in West Bengal, Madinapur district. And our railway minister is Piyush Goyal. He is also the minister for coal. As per United Nations, which of the following is the most violent region in the world for women? So it is not Asia, it is not India, it is in fact Latin America and Caribbean. Caribbean is what you call the West Indies area, that one. And Latin America is nothing but South America. Spanish Latin is the language there. So it is called Latin America. Most of the countries except Brazil and one or two more, they speak Latin in South America. Brazil language is Portuguese, it is not Latin. So remember that. And this is the most violent for women. Which institute's team has won the Niti Aayog prize in the India Chain category at the inaugural edition of the Proffer Hackathon that was organized at IIT Delhi? It was won by IIITM Kerala. Kerala has two important dances, one is Kathakali, one is Mohiniyattam, and Kerala's chief minister is Pinaray Vijayan of the CPIM party. They won in the blockchain based transparent marketplace called AgroChain. So that was won by IITM Kerala. Kerala's governor is P. Satashivam. Who has been appointed as the first ever woman pilot in the Indian Navy and will be flying a maritime reconnaissance aircraft very, very soon? Her name is Shubhangi Swaroop. Now the other three are also very important because they are women cadet and they are also first women officers at the Naval Armament Inspectorate. However, pilot position is given to Shubhangi Swaroop, and our Navy chief is Sunil Lamba. A consultative workshop was conducted on the new national policy on biofuel and Pradhan Mantri G1 Yojana VGF for second generation ethanol biorefinery. It was held where? Now remember, India's largest refinery is set up at Ratnagiri recently, at an investment of 2 lakh crore rupees by three companies: Indian Oil Corporation, HPCL Hindustan Petroleum, and third is Bharat Petroleum BPCL. Remember that Bharat Petroleum is the 8th Maharatan company in India. It has been given a Maharatan status. And these three companies, what is the shareholding? Indian Oil Corporation has 50% stake, and Indian Oil Corporation is the most profitable PSU in India. HPCL has 25%, and the remaining 25% is with BPCL. It is set up at Ratnagiri in Maharashtra, and this particular workshop, it was conducted in the capital New Delhi. And our oil and gas minister, also the minister for skill development, is Dharmendra Pradhan. Which state government has approved a ₹635 crore irrigation scheme, which is named Navakrishna Chaudhary Secha Unayan Yojana? Navakrishna Chaudhary was a freedom fighter from Odisha. So the answer is Odisha. And this gentleman is Naveen Patnaik. Odisha's capital is Bhubaneswar, which will host the Hockey World Cup in 2018. And Odisha hosted Asian Athletics Championship also recently, and India finished at the top. The mascot for that was Oli, which is basically an olive ridley turtle, which is usually found at the Gahirmath beach. Now remember, just now the AIBA Youth Boxing Championship has ended, and its mascot is Guppy. And for the FIFA Under 17 Football World Cup that took place in India, the mascot is Kheleo the Clouded Leopard. Which bank has been added to a list of the 30 of the world's most systemically important banks? Which means these banks are too big to fail, and if one of the banks fail, then it will affect the global economy. It is the only bank from Canada, and the first bank from Canada. It is called the Royal Bank of Canada. Canada's defense minister is Harjit Singh. Prime minister is Justin Trudeau. Montreal, a place in Canada, is the headquarter of World Anti-Doping Agency. Capital is Ottawa. And a total 30 banks are domestic systemically important. Now in India, there are three banks which are domestic systemically important: ICICI Bank, State Bank of India, and HDFC Bank. Our central government has approved signing of an agreement with which country? And together we will mutually cooperate in the custom matters. This country is the Philippines. And Philippines' capital is Manila, which is the headquarter of Asian Development Bank. And Rodrigo Duterte is the president of Philippines. Union Cabinet has approved wage policy for the 8th round of wage negotiations for workmen in the central public sector enterprises, which is called CPSE. Now, it will benefit more than 9.35 lakh workmen. And this wage revision is issued by which department? It is issued by the Department of Public Enterprises, DPE. Now, remember, our labor minister is Santosh Kumar Gangwar. Earlier, it was Bandaru Dattatreya, but now he is Santosh Kumar Gangwar. Which bank has launched a loan scheme for the rural women in Andhra Pradesh? This is named the Patabi Sitaramaya Self-Business Group Scheme. This is named after the founder of this bank, Mr. Patabi Sitaramaya, whose 138th birth anniversary was recently celebrated. This is the Andhra Bank. And managing director and CEO of this bank is Mr. Suresh Patel. Which city has become the first city in the world to jointly host the Badminton and Para-Badminton World Championships upon being awarded the hosting rights for the event to be held in 2019? Which city I'm talking about? I'm talking about Basel in Switzerland. Roger Federer is a player who was born in Basel in Switzerland. And Roger Federer this year in 2017, he won the Wimbledon and Australian Open. Now, we are Basel III compliant, which means we have to maintain a risk is to weighted assets ratio, also called capital adequacy ratio, by 2019 March 31st. And and remember that the Badminton World Federation, BWF, it is headquartered in Kuala Lumpur, which is the capital of Malaysia. And recently, our badminton champion, Saina Nehwal, she beat PV Sindhu to win the badminton championship. How many MOUs has our central government signed under the UDAY scheme? UDAY is Usual Discom Assurance Yojana by the Ministry of Power, and our power minister, also the Minister for Renewable Energy, is Mr. R.K. Singh. Total, we have signed 4 MOU. Now, we have signed these MOU with Nagaland, Andaman Nicobar, Dadra Nagar Haveli and Daman and Diu. Now, there are 27 states in India and 4 union territories which have adopted UDAY scheme. So, only 2 states and 3 union territories have not done so. Can you name the 2 states which have not yet signed the UDAY scheme of the central government? Let's see who answers this question. 13th edition of the Asia-Europe Foreign Ministers meeting was recently held at which place? And this woman is Aung San Suu Kyi. She is the foreign minister of Myanmar. And this was held in the capital of Myanmar, Naypyi Taw. Now remember one more gentleman, Htin Kyaw. He is the president of Myanmar. Myanmar's old name is Burma and old capital is Rangoon. And Myanmar came into the issue because of the Rohingya Muslim issue. It came to the fore. Rakhine is the state where most of the Rohingya Muslims live. World Fisheries Day, it was observed on which date? This is for the development of fisheries. Very, very important. Very, very important for the global food consumption. And it was established by the World Fisheries Forum, also called WFF. It is headquartered in Kampala. Now remember, Kampala is the capital of Uganda. Don't confuse Uganda with Rwanda. Rwanda is the African, both are African country. Rwanda's capital is Kigali. So World Fisheries Day is observed on November the 21st. Which of the following companies has been declared ineligible to be awarded any contract by the World Bank for the next 2 years? This is the Madhukon project and they are very, very lethargic. They showed a lot of inconsistency and negligence in the Lucknow Muzaffarpur highway. That is why World Bank is angry and it has said that Madhukon projects will not be awarded any projects. And World Bank president is Jim Yong Kim. It is headquartered in Washington DC along with IMF and NASA. And World Bank CEO is Kristina Georgieva. Which bank has recently launched initiatives? So many initiatives. It has launched a digital library, a field recovery mobile application, a retail loan vehicle, a tracking system, and a regulatory guided tracking system. All these things have been launched by Canara Bank. It is based in Karnataka along with Syndicate Bank and Bank of Karnataka and Vijaya Bank. All these are from Karnataka. Canara Bank, Mr. Rakesh Sharma is the managing director and CEO. And this bank was founded in 1906. Very old bank. And recently they celebrated their Founders Day also. Which city will host the ORISIS's first Asia meet in India? This honor is given to Kolkata City of Joy, capital of West Bengal. Remember, West Bengal is also a partner in the event. Now, one more thing. Recently concluded India International Trade Fair in Delhi. It was the 37th India International Trade Fair. Partner state is Jharkhand. Partner country is Vietnam. And focus country is Kazakhstan. India recently conducted a mock tsunami exercise to check our operational preparedness if at all we have a tsunami in India. So this was conducted on the eastern coast of India across how many states and union territory. So you can know all the eastern ones, start from Kolkata right here in West Bengal, then come down Odisha, then Andhra Pradesh, then Tamil Nadu. So West Bengal, Odisha, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, and of course Puducherry. So the answer is five states and union territories. Which space agency has completed the first test of its March 2020 missions parachute testing series, which is called Aspire, Advanced Supersonic Parachute Inflation Research Experiment? This has been conducted by NASA. NASA wants to send Mars, shuttle on Mars in 2020. So Mars rover mission will launch in 2020. NASA is headquartered in Washington, D.C. SpaceX, Elon Musk is the CEO, and Falcon 9 rocket is of SpaceX. And ISRO is Indian. A.S. Kiran Kumar is the chairman, headquartered in Bengaluru. ESA is European Space Agency. Who was adjudged as the best actor at the Asia Pacific Screen Awards that was held in Brisbane in Australia? His name is Rajkumar Rao. You'll be surprised to know that Rajkumar Rao was my senior in my school. So he was a great actor then also. He used to be very active in sports and drama. In fact, one time I remember he performed on Ma Tujhe Salam song on the stage, and it was simply enthralling. So Rajkumar Rao, he played the character of Newton in the movie Newton, directed by Amit Masurkar, and it is the official entry of India to the Oscars this year. Which company has tied up with Mahindra and Mahindra to explore deployment of the electric vehicles on its platform? Who wants electric vehicles on its platform? The CEO of this company is Dara Khosrow Shahi. It is Uber. The main competitor of Uber is Ola. Ola CEO is Bhavish Agarwal. Now remember, Mahindra and Mahindra chairman, everybody knows Anand Mahindra. But who is the managing director of Mahindra Mahindra? Managing director is Mr. Pavan Goenka. India has signed an agreement with which country for visa-free entry of the crew of both the chartered and scheduled flight? This we have signed with our close friend Russia. Remember, recently BrahMos was tested, and BrahMos we have got with the help of Russia. BrahMos stands for Bra, stands for BRAH, stand in BrahMos stands for Brahmaputra, and MOS stands for the river Moskva, which is in Russia. And Bhilai steel plant, Kundankulam nuclear power plant, I mean, there's so much Russia has done for us. Very all weather friend. Even in 1971 war with Pakistan, Russia helped us. In 1965 war with China, Russia gave us important weapons. So Russia is all weather friend. Russia's capital is Moscow. It has Red Square. Saint Petersburg, beautiful city, is there. Moscow capital. Vladimir Putin is president. Russia will also host the 2018 FIFA Football World Cup. IMBEX 2017. This exercise was conducted in the beautiful state of Meghalaya at Umroi. Now this is a military exercise between India and which other country? It is between India and Myanmar. Meghalaya's capital is Shillong, and it has Nokrek National Park and Balfakram National Park, and it also has Khasi, Jayantia, and Garo Hills. Our central government has approved the continuation of the scheme on Indian Institute of Corporate Affairs for another how many years? This they have extended till 2019-20 for another 3 years. Now Indian Institute of Corporate Affairs is present in Gurugram. Gurugram was earlier called Gurugaon. It is in Haryana. Now remember, there is another place in Haryana called Ballabgarh. It has been now renamed to Balramgarh. And there is an Amin village. It has been now renamed to Abhimanyupur after the son of Arjuna, who was called Abhimanyu in Mahabharata. Who won the silver medal in the under 23 senior world wrestling championship that was held in Poland? Poland's capital is Warsaw. Her name is Ritu Fogat. She is daughter of Mahavir Fogat, on whose life Dangal movie was made. The role of Mahavir Fogat was played by Amir Khan. So her name is Ritu Fogat. By the way, Ritu Fogat is on song. She recently won the national championship also that was held in Indore in November. And also, Indore is the cleanest city of India as per the cleanliness survey. Biju Phukan, he passed away. He was a famous what? So he was a very, very famous Assamese actor. So the answer is actor. He was from Assam. Capital is Dispur, and it has Debru Saikhova National Park, Sonai Rupai National Park, and Manas Kaziranga, wild, you know, national parks also famous for one horned rhino. And Amchang is a place. It's a wildlife sanctuary also, and Amchang is a place from where eviction drive is going on. There are a lot of protests going on in Assam at this point in time. And governor is Jagdish Mukhi. It has a dance also called Bihu. Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development, OECD, is headquartered in Paris along with UNESCO. Now, OECD Global Forum on Transparency and Exchange of Information for Tax Purposes, it has lowered India's rating by a notch from compliant to what? India is not compliant, India is largely compliant. So they have downgraded our ratings. However, Moody's has been rather charitable towards India, and they have upped the ratings from Baa3 to Baa2, and they have changed our status from stable to positive. So that's what Moody's have done, but OECD has done the opposite. Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs, CCEA, they have said that the schemes under Ministry of Women and Child Development, headed by Manika Gandhi, who is a Lok Sabha MP from Pilibhit in Uttar Pradesh. Now, how much money will Ministry of Child Development schemes get for the next 3 years from 2017 to 2019-20. The allocation is 3636 crore rupees. Who has been sworn in as a judge in Madras High Court? And the oath is given by the Chief Justice of Madras High Court, Indira Banerjee, and you can see her in the photograph here. The name of the judge is Shatrughan Pujari. Which state's cabinet has approved electronic system design and manufacturing policy for next 5 years, 2017 to 2022? This policy is given is by Karnataka. And what is this policy? Now there will be 5 hardware accelerators that will be set up in Karnataka at 5 places. Which are these 5 places? Mysuru, Bengaluru, Mangaluru, Kalaburgi and Shivamogga. These are the 5 places. Karnataka has an important dance called Yakshagan. There is a dance called Dolu Kunitha and of course Hattara. These are 3 important dances. Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, headed by JP Nadda, who is our health minister, it has launched a 15-day long initiative from November 21 to December the 4 to raise awareness about what? This is called male vasectomy. Male vasectomy is done by the males so that they don't become fathers for family planning. And the theme this year was Jimmevar Purush ki yahi hai pehchan, parivar niyojan mein jo de yogdan, which means a responsible man is the one. He can be identified by his responsibility towards his, fulfillment of his responsibility towards family planning. Who has been appointed as the special ambassador for adolescents and HIV by UNAIDS, UNAIDS, United Nations Organization for Controlling AIDS? By the way, 1st December is the World AIDS Day. And it is Mr. Quraisha Abdul Karim. Quraisha Abdul Karim, she is the woman, actually it's a female. HIV positive, there is a person called Pradeep Kumar. From Manipur, his life, there is a book written called I am HIV positive, so what, written by Jayant Kalita, and he's a bodybuilder. Who inaugurated the 5th global conference on cyberspace? And this, by the way, this conference, which is called GCCS or Global Conference on Cyberspace, is the largest in the world. The theme was Cyber for All, a secure and inclusive cyberspace for sustainable development. Last year, this same conference, it took place in The Hague, which is in Netherlands, which is the headquarters of International Court of Justice. This time it was inaugurated by Narendra Modi. Who has been named the highest earning woman in the music industry by Forbes magazine? Her name is Beyoncé. She is the highest earner. Second is Adele and third is Taylor Swift. Now my second question for you today. There is a song that was sung by Adele last year, which was the most viewed song on YouTube. Can you name that song? It's a very common expression when we meet someone. International Day for the Elimination of Violence Against Women. It was observed recently. The theme was Leave No One Behind, End Violence Against Women and Girls. When was it observed? It was observed on November the 25th. Now remember one thing. There was a campaign that was launched which is called Orange the World. India has sent a proposal to the United Nations for declaring which year as the International Year of Millets. Now millets is a popular crop in India, but India is still lagging behind in crops like maize, for example. So India has requested United Nations to declare 2018 as the year of millets. Now remember, this is done by Dr. M.S. Swaminathan, who is also called the father of green revolution in India. Who has been appointed as the Director General of Doordarshan News? Her name is Ira Joshi. She will replace Veena Jain, whose tenure is over now. There is a tribal festival called Parab 2017. It was held in Koraput. In which place? Koraput is a Naxalite affected area. It's a very backward place in Odisha. It is very underdeveloped. And there is a fair also, fest also, which is called Palli Shri Fest. It will also be organized in Odisha. Development of Northeastern Region. It's a dedicated department for the development of our Northeastern states. So the minister for that is Dr. Jitendra Singh. He launched a World Bank backed project, which is called Northeast Rural Livelihood Project in how many states? Very, very important question. It has been launched in 4 states. Mizoram, Nagaland, Sikkim and Tripura. Mizoram, Nagaland, Sikkim and Tripura. MNST, just make a formula. But this might not work because M stands for Manipur, Mizoram, Meghalaya. So you might get confused. So just make it MINST so that it is Mizoram. Now, Nagaland has Intanki National Park and Hornbill Festival is also very popular from Nagaland. Sikkim's Chief Minister Pawan Chamling, he was awarded for organic contribution. Sikkim is the first organic state in India and first open defecation free state in India. There is a volcano which is called Mount Agung. It recently erupted. And last time it erupted was in 1963. It is located at which place? In fact, last time it erupted, more than 1500 people were killed. So it erupted in Bali, which is in Indonesia. Indonesia's capital is Jakarta. Jakarta is the secretariat of ASEAN countries. World Bank has provided India a loan of how much for new and renewable energy solar park scheme? And under this scheme, there will be two solar parks that will be set up at Rewa and at Mandsaur. Now, both the places are in Madhya Pradesh. World Bank is providing us a loan of 100 million USD. And our renewable energy target is 175 gigawatt by 2022. Which state government has partnered with Samsung India to set up 20 new smart healthcare center to provide healthcare equipment? Samsung is a company from South Korea and this state is Uttar Pradesh. Yogi Adityanath is the CM, Ram Naik is the governor, Dudhwa National Park is there and also Naroda Atomic Power Plant is there. United Nations conference, which is called COP23, Conference of the Parties 23, it recently concluded in Germany at a place called Bonn. Now, Germany, recently there was adoption of which roadmap? It is called the Talanoa Dialogue. And remember, COP24 will take place next year in Poland. And also remember that in COP23, the chairmanship was of Fiji, the presidency was of Fiji. Fiji's capital is Suva. India recently test fired which of the missiles from Sukhoi 30 MKI fighter jet plane? Again, Sukhoi is given to us by Russia only. And remember one thing, that this missile is BrahMos, and BrahMos is the only cruise missile in the world which can be fired from air, land and water. All the three. With this, earlier it could be fired from only water and land, but now it can be fired from air also, because we have just test fired it from Sukhoi and it has worked brilliantly. So that is something to worry about for China and Pakistan. Now remember that it is developed by Defense Research Development Organization. Dr. S. Christopher is the chairman of DRDO, and it is also with the help of Russia's NPO organization. Which insurance company has started Life Assist? It is a digital platform that can provide 24/7 insurance solution. It is started by Bajaj Allianz Life Insurance. And remember, they had also launched a platform called Boeing, B-O-I-N-G. Don't confuse it with Boeing. Boeing is an American aircraft manufacturer. Which institute has tied up with Space Applications Center, SSC, and ISRO to identify the potential fishing zones? This has been done by the Central Marine Fisheries Research Institute, which is called CMFRI. And the project which they are launching is called Samudra. Samudra means sea in English. Which state government has recently passed a bill to regulate private healthcare? Now, hell has broken loose and all the doctors are on strike. They are saying it is a way to strangulate the private healthcare. This is the KPME, infamous KPME bill in Karnataka. Cabinet has given its approval for signing of a MOU with which country? Together we will cooperate to control terrorism and organized crime. This country is again Russia. How many gold medals did India win at the AIBA World Women's Youth Boxing Championship that was held in Guwahati in Assam? India won 5 gold medals and 2 bronze medals. And India finished top. And this has happened for the first time in the AIBA World Women's Youth Boxing Championship. Mary Kom from Manipur, she was the brand ambassador. She is 5 times world champion, 5 times Asian champion and 1 time Olympic bronze medalist also. And the mascot was Guppy, which is a one-horned rhino. Which country has recently launched 3 remote sensing satellites for its Jilin 1 constellation? This country is China. And what is their rocket name? It is called Long March. And their space agency is called CNSA. New Development Bank, it is also called BRICS Bank. It has approved 2 projects in India and Russia. Total loan, how much? Total loan is $400 million. Mr. KV Kamath, he is the president of New Development Bank. Now remember that it is giving a loan to Russia. But why it is giving loan to India? This is for the Indira Gandhi Canal project upgradation. Who has been appointed to head the newly formed Hill Area Development Committee by the government of West Bengal? It is Mr. Man Ghishing. He is also the president of Gurkha National Liberation Front, GNNF. They are demanding a separate Gurkha land. There was a 2-day conference of all commanders of the Eastern Air Command, which commenced at which place? It took place in Shillong, in Meghalaya. And our Chief of Air Staff, Air Chief Marshal B.S. Dhanwa, also participated. International seminar was conducted on Indian space program. The title was Trends and Opportunities for Industry, and it was organized by FICCI, Federation of Indian Chambers of Commerce and Industry, Antriksh Corporation. Now remember, Antriksh is the commercial arm of ISRO and of course ISRO. So where was this held? It was held in New Delhi. Who is going to head the task force that has been formed by the Ministry of Finance to review the Income Tax Act of 1961 and to draft a new direct tax law? Now CBDT chairman is Mr. Sushil Chandra, and this will be headed by Mr. Arvind Modi. And also our Chief Economic Advisor Arvind Subramanian will be a permanent special invitee. Central government has requested which state to enhance their target of road construction Under the Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana from 7000 km to 10000 km, central government has requested the government of Odisha for the same. And our Minister for Road Transport is Nitin Gadkari, who is a Lok Sabha MP from Nagpur in Maharashtra. Which of the following company they have introduced its digital training and startup training hub in India, which is aimed at helping the small business? It is Facebook. Facebook CEO is Mark Zuckerberg and COO is Sheryl Sandberg. Now remember, Facebook had also started earlier She Means Business program. She Means Business. World Trade Organization, it has established a panel to review the dispute between which two countries. It is between Qatar and UAE, that is the fight for supremacy in the Middle East. Qatar's capital is Doha. Qatar, by the way, will host the 2022 FIFA Football World Cup also. And UAE capital is Abu Dhabi. Now, World Trade Organization, you should remember one thing about it, that its director general is Mr. Roberto Azevedo. This they have asked in exam a lot of time. Roberto Azevedo. UNICEF is Anthony Lake. WHO is Tedros Adhanom. UNHCR, United Nations High Commissioner for Refugees, Filippo Grandi. So remember some of as much as you can. Sangai Festival, it is celebrated where? It was recently celebrated. Why they call it Sangai Festival? Because there is a deer which is called Sangai and it can be found only at this national park, which is called Kibul Lamjao National Park. Where is it? It is in Manipur. In fact, this festival was inaugurated by 14th President of India, Ramnath Kovind. So answer is Manipur. ISRO Chairman, Indian Space Research Organization Chairman Mr. A.S. Kiran Kumar, he said that India will start their first mission to the Sun. It will be called Aditya L1. When we will launch mission to Sun? We will launch it in 2019. And also remember, Chandrayaan 2 to the Moon will be sent in 2018 March. Who inaugurated the first World Conference on the Access to Medical Products and International Law for Trade and Health? It was inaugurated in New Delhi. This is done by our Health Minister Mr. J.P. Nadda. Which state government has launched a mobile app? It is called Dishari. This provides free study material for competitive examination. Soon, StudyIQ is also launching its mobile app. Just wait for 15-20 more days and that will also provide free study material for competitive examination. So this is launched by the government of Rajasthan. Now they have also launched another app called MIS. This is for geotagging all the government colleges. CM is Vasundhara Raje, Kalyan Singh is the governor. They have Desert National Park, Sariska National Park, SRK. So Ranthambore and Bharatpur National Park. What is the name of the mobile app launched by Pradhan Mantri Narendra Modi that will upgrade the electronic governance through the mobile devices? It is called, now pay attention to the full form here, Unified Mobile Application for New Age Governance. In short, Umang. Della Res, she passed away. She was a famous word. She was a singer. She was also a TV actress. She is known for the show Touched by an Angel. In how many cities in India has the Home Ministry launched Safe City Plan for Women? They will basically be emergency response system and police verified public transport. This they have done in 8 major cities of India: Delhi, Mumbai, Kolkata, Chennai, Ahmedabad, Bengaluru, Lucknow and Hyderabad. What is the name of the movement that is launched by the Federation of Obstetrics and Gynecological Societies of India for spreading the awareness for the need of quality care for mothers during and immediately after the childbirth? This is called Manyata, and it was launched by Shilpa Shetty and Pankaja Munde. Jana Novotna, she passed away. She was associated with which sport? She is one of the greatest players to honor tennis. She's a tennis player. She has won 17 Grand Slams and she is from Czech Republic. Capital of Czech Republic is Prague. Who is the new president of Zimbabwe? Robert Mugabe, 93-year-old. He wanted his wife to take over, but military threw him away. And now the new president is Emmerson Mnangagwa. Zimbabwe's capital is Harare. Our Agriculture and Farmer Welfare Minister Radha Mohan Singh, who is a Lok Sabha MP from Purvi Champaran in Bihar, he has announced that India has become the dash largest fish producing country in the world. India is the second largest fish producing country in the world. Delhi and District Cricket Association DDCA, it has recently named Gate 3 and Gate 4 of Firoz Shah Kotla Stadium after which cricket player? Now remember, Firoz Shah Kotla Stadium is the same stadium where Anil Kumble took 10 wickets in one innings against Pakistan. It is very famous stadium in New Delhi. It has been named after Anjum Chopra, who represented India in 6 World Cups. Long career Indian ex-Indian cricket team captain. Now it is of course Mithali Raj. Now remember, Firoz Shah Kotla ground, they have named a gate after Virendra Sehwag also recently. Noted jurist Habibullah Bash, he passed away. He was the founder director of which hospital? He was the founder and director of Apollo Hospitals. Our central government has approved India's membership for which important organization? It is called the European Bank for Reconstruction and Development, EBRD. Now, one important thing is that the president of this bank is Indian and the name is Mr. Suma Chakraborty. and it is headquartered in London, capital of England. What is the theme of the 8th Global Entrepreneurship Summit that was held in Hyderabad? It was jointly inaugurated by Modi, and she is daughter of Ivanka. She is Ivanka Trump, daughter of Donald Trump. So what was the theme? The theme is Women First, Prosperity for All. Union Cabinet has approved to set up 15th Finance Commission. Its recommendations will cover a 5-year period commencing from which financial year? It will be the financial year 21. That means 2020 to 21. Now remember one more thing, that the 14th Finance Commission is what we are having right now from 2013 to 2000. It started in 2013 and it was set up in 2013, started functioning. It will end functioning in 2020-21, and the chairman of 14th Finance Commission is Dr. Y.V. Reddy, who is the ex-governor of the Reserve Bank of India. Which of the following companies has partnered with Airtel Payment Bank to power its mobile wallet? Airtel Payment Bank was the first payment bank in India, and the company is Hike Wallet. By the way, Hike founder, they ask in exam, his name is Kavin Bharti Mittal. Which state is going to host the 6th edition of Swimathon? It's a swimming championship organized by the Square of Sports. It is Goa. Goa's chief minister is Manohar Parikar, ex-defense minister of India, and governor is Mridula Sinha. Now remember that Olympian Virdhaval Khade, if you remember the Olympic game, Virdhaval Khade was the youngest swimmer to represent India at the Olympics. Virdhaval Khade, he is the brand ambassador. Who has resigned as the CEO of UBS India? It is Ashish Kamath. How many memorandum of understanding worth 5000 crore they were signed during the Northeast Development Summit that was held in Imphal, capital of Manipur? Total number of MOU is 39. Who is the nominee of India at the International Court of Justice who has been re-elected for a period of 9 years? There are 15 judges in the International Court of Justice headquartered in The Hague in Netherlands. His name is Dalveer Bhandari. And whom did he beat? He beat UK's Christopher Greenwood. This is the first time the UK is not represented in the 15 judges. Which Indian automobile company opened its new manufacturing plant in Detroit, making it the city's first automotive production facility in 25 years? Now, Detroit is also called World's Car Capital. Where is Detroit? It is in the Michigan state in United States of America. The company is Mahindra. Chairman is Anand Mahindra. Managing director is Pavan Goenka. Who has won the Shakti Bhatt First Book Prize 2017 for his novel The Story of a Brief Marriage? It is Mr. Anuk Arud Pragasam. And he was also awarded the DSC Prize for South Asian Literature 2017 recently. Which bank has partnered with the Mumbai Police to launch a safe banking promotion campaign called Muh Pe Tala, which means keep your mouth shut? What does it mean? It means that don't disclose your OTP, your passwords, your CVV and anything, any detail to anyone. So which bank has launched it? It is the Axis Bank. Shikha Sharma is the managing director. Which bank has launched the first comprehensive digital banking service platform, which is called YONO? You only need one. It is the State Bank of India. And this gentleman is the new chairman. His name is Rajneesh Kumar. Delta Corp Limited, they set up the first casino game training course in India at which place? The first casino game training course is launched in Goa. What is India's rank out of 63 countries on the World Talent Ranking compiled by IMD? India's rank is a dismal 51. Number 1 rank is Switzerland, number 2 Denmark, number 3 Belgium. Belgium's capital Brussels is the headquarters of NATO. Our road transport minister, Nitin Gadkari, he has announced 1 lakh crore infrastructure projects. For which state? He has launched it for Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu has Mukurthi National Park and Guindi National Park. These are two important ones. And Tamil Nadu's Mukhya Mantri CM is Edappadi Palaniswamy of the AIADMK party. Which Indian university has become the youngest to be ranked in an international ranking by featuring in the top 10 private institutes in India by the QS Quackrulli Simons University ranking? It is the OP Jindal Global University in Haryana. Which state cabinet has approved amendments to the law governing the cooperative society to allow the people to contest the mergers of the certain society? This decision has been taken by the Punjab government, and they will modify the Punjab Cooperatives Societies Act of 1961. So, next. Journalist Sudeep Datta Bhaumik, he passed away. He was from which state? Sudeep Datta Bhaumik, he was from Tripura, capital is Agartala. Mangi Bhai Arya passed away. He was a famous what? Mangi Bhai Arya, he was a singer from Rajasthan. The library of which university has bagged the highest profile registration category award for effective utilization of the J-Gate at eShodh Sindhu platform? This is the University of Pondicherry. Which state government has launched a portal called Arpan to improve the delivery service for pensioner. Now, pension is given by Pension Fund Regulatory Development Authority of India. Chairman of PFRDA is Hemant Contractor. And which state government has launched ARPAN? It is the government of Odisha. Reserve Bank of India has relaxed the rules for the asset reconstruction companies with net owned fund of 100 crore rupees. Now, these asset reconstruction companies, they are exempted from the shareholding cap of how much percent on the post-converted equity of the borrower company. The cap is 26% and they have been exempted from it. Also, asset reconstruction companies, they are taking the stressed asset from our bank so that we can have a good capital adequacy ratio. National Foundation for Communal Harmony, NFCH, they observed Communal Harmony Campaign and Fundraising Week from which date to which date. They organized it from November the 19th to 25. As per a report by sheetwork.com, which state in India has the highest number of women entrepreneurs in India? In fact, of all the entrepreneurs in India, 80% women are from this state. It is Tamil Nadu. MSwipe, it has partnered with which of the following companies to launch Asia's first digital merchant onboarding solution? Which company is this? It is MasterCard. Now remember, MasterCard's president and CEO is an Indian. His name is Ajay Pal Banga. Similarly, Shantanu Narayan of Adobe is also Indian. Sundar Pichai of Google is also Indian. Satya Nadella of Microsoft is also Indian. So remember some of these high profile CEOs. Government has raised the issue size of Bharat 22 Electronic Credit Fund. By the way, Bharat 22 is managed by ICICI Prudential Mutual Fund. And now the issue size earlier was 8,000 crore. Now it has been renamed to 14,500 crore rupees. Which bank has received Securities and Exchange Board of India's approval for issue of equity shares worth 1,000 crore through institutional placement? Which bank is this? It is the United Bank of India headquartered in Kolkata. Pawan Kumar Bajaj is the Managing Director and CEO. SEBI's Chairman is Ajay Tyagi. Who is author of the book Age of Anger? This book has won the non-fiction category award at the Tata Literature Live Award. By the way, at Tata Literature Live, Girish Karnad, he won the Lifetime Achievement Award. This book is written by Mr. Pankaj Mishra. Which state has set up a gender budget cell to monitor the implementation of welfare schemes for women and children so that the schemes can be implemented easily and effectively? This has been done by the government of Maharashtra. Devendra Fadnavis is the CM and Maharashtra Governor is Vidyasagar Rao. So that's it. November is over now. December starts. 3rd December, I will post the first part of the first week of December. Now remember, first week of December, I am reiterating that I will cover it in 3 parts. First week will be covered in 3 parts and a lot of questions will be there. So get ready for your future exams. Thanks a lot.